Church Cathedral, Oxford, for choral evensong on St. Peter's Day. The canticles are sung to the ninth service by Thomas Wilkes, and the anthem is Palestrina's Petertide motet, Tu es Petrus, Thou art Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church. The service opens with the setting of the Preces by William Smith.
Psalms 142 and 143.
Thank you. first lesson.
Thank you.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth,
and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Commanded him earnestly to feed thy flock. Make, we beseech thee, all bishops and pastors diligently to preach thy holy word, and the people obediently to follow the same, that they may receive the crown of everlasting glory. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that both our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee we, being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness, through the merits of Jesus Christ our Savior. Lighten our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of thy only Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ.
us pray. Father of mercies, who to thine apostle Saint Peter didst reveal in threefold vision thy boundless compassion, forgive, we pray thee, our unbelief, and so enlarge our hearts and enkindle our zeal, that we may fervently desire the salvation of all men, and with more ready diligence labor in the extension of thy kingdom. For his sake who gave himself for the life of the world, thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Almighty and everlasting God, who hast willed to restore all things in thy well-beloved Son, the King and Lord of all, mercifully grant that all peoples and nations, divided and wounded by sin, may be brought under the gentle yoke of his most loving rule, who with thee and the Holy Spirit liveth and reigneth, ever one God, world without end. Amen.
Amen.
Pray for God's blessing on the worship offered in this place. O Lord Jesus Christ, who art thyself the temple of the holy city of God, the light thereof and its surpassing glory, glorify and lighten, we beseech thee, with thy perpetual presence, this earthly house built gloriously to thee, and be pleased both to inspire and to accept its worship day by day, the praise of thankful lips and the prayers of faithful hearts, who livest and reignest with the Father and the Holy Ghost, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Show thy loving kindness tonight, O Lord, to all who stand in need of thy help. Be with the weak to make them strong, and with the strong to make them gentle. Cheer the lonely with thy company, and the worried with thy peace. Prosper thy church in the fulfillment of her mighty task, and grant thy blessing to all who have toiled today, in Christ's name. Amen. And the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.
Amen.
Hymn number 370.